Hello, in this video, I'm going to be talking about bisphosphonates. You may know these drugs as pimidronate or zoledronate, and they have brand names as well that we'll put right in the captions below. Before I go on, I want to invite you to subscribe to our channel. We're always putting out new content, so there's always something new to watch, and we will do a video of a topic you're interested in if you let us know. I'd also love to invite you to go to yerbba.com to get your personalized Yerbba report. So let's talk a moment about bone. Bone is really interesting. We're constantly breaking down and rebuilding bone. Even as I sit here talking to you today, my bone is breaking down and it's rebuilding. And there are two different kinds of cells, osteoclasts, which break bone down, and osteoblasts, which build bone up. The bisphosphonates are a class of medication that you can have IV or by mouth. These drugs are advertised on television. Sally Fields does an advertisement for Boniva because she's on an oral bisphosphonate. In breast cancer care, we often give these medications IV. And the hope with these medications is to shift more toward the bone build up than the bone build down. Well, why would your bone build down? Why would our bone be more in the shifting towards the bone breaking down level? Well, this happens with time. With time, as we make less estrogen, estrogen's involved in keeping the bones strong. And so just with time alone, we're losing bone mineral density. Both men and women, people with and without ovaries, will lose bone mass over time. Why specifically with breast cancer? Well, there are a couple things that cause an increase in the risk of bone mineral loss, and those are chemotherapy, probably because of a couple factors. One, to prevent you from being nauseated and vomiting all night, we give you corticosteroids like dexamethasone or prednisone, and these keep you from getting sick. But when you are on corticosteroids for quite a while, even if it's just 4 treatments or 8 treatments, these corticosteroids can decrease bone mineral density. So that's probably why chemotherapy causes bone breakdown more than a steady state that we're all in as we sit here. The other thing is people receiving chemotherapy are less active. Even if you want to stay active, although you might be a runner and you're still running, so don't yell at me in the comments, but there are people who do less walking and weightlifting, and we tell them don't pick up a heavy load of laundry after your surgery. That absence of pressure on the bones, pressure is good for the bones, that absence of pressure can hasten turnover of the bone and shift more towards the breaking down. Then 2 hormonal therapies I'm going to talk about. One is tamoxifen. Now, if you're postmenopausal, if your ovaries are no longer making estrogen, tamoxifen is actually good for the bones. If you're premenopausal, it competes with the estrogen in your body, and it actually can increase your risk of bone mineral density. Plus, premenopausal people are more likely to get chemotherapy, so you get these additive effects. So tamoxifen in postmenopausal women, good for bone. Tamoxifen in premenopausal women, not so good. Combined with other treatments and inactivity can be a problem. The other class of medication that can impact your bone health are the aromatase inhibitors. Aromatase inhibitors, remember, decrease estrogen in your body, and by doing so, don't have that protective effect of estrogen that all of us still have after menopause, but estrogen being protective, decreasing the production of estrogen, can actually be bad for bones. Now, most people don't shift from normal bone mineral density to osteoporosis or really fragile bones, but definitely bone mineral density will go down on the aromatase inhibitors until you come off, and then your bone mineral density will go to where it would have been at your age as if you weren't ever on an aromatase inhibitor. People on longer-term therapy because of metastatic disease, you won't get that rebound effect until you stop the medication. Bisphosphonates have been shown to improve bone mineral density, whether IV or by mouth. Bisphosphonates also prevent fractures and pain and the need for surgery. So not just the measurement on your DEXA test, but also the risk of having complications of osteopenia or osteoporosis. So they're really good for strengthening your bones and decreasing some really bad things like surgery on the bones and fractures and needing pain medication, strong pain medication. So they're good for bones. There's also a possibility that in some people they may decrease the risk of breast cancer recurrence. The studies have been some positive, some negative, but if your doctor offers you a bisphosphonate for your bone health, be assured that it's not going to increase your risk of breast cancer. If anything, it may improve your outcome. Last, I want to mention, for people with metastatic breast cancer who have breast cancer metastases to bone, the bisphosphonates are a mainstay of treatment. In addition to treating the cancer, we want to also improve your bone mineral density to prevent those other things like fracture, pain medicine, or needing surgery. I've covered a lot. We can talk about bisphosphonate side effects in another video. I'd be happy to do that. I'm gonna stop right here. I've covered a lot. I hope it's been helpful. Put any questions or comments below. We always love to hear from you. And don't forget to subscribe and go to yerbba.com for your personalized Yerbba report.